हेलो, आई एम प्रभु वेनमरज, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, बीएड ईसीटी, विजयपुर. सो आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ गाइडलाइंस फॉर हाउ टू प्रिपेयर योर सेमिनार और प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट. सो दीज आर द यूनिवर्सिटी गाइडलाइंस टू प्रिपेयर अ सेमिनार और प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट. द पेपर साइज शुड बी A4, मार्जिन्स लेफ्ट 1.25, राइट 1, टॉप एंड बॉटम एज 0.75, and chapters left or right justified, and font size is 16, title of the chapter is centered, and font size is 18, and sections numbered in a decimal form, left justified, and font size is 16, and subsection numbered in a decimal form, and left justified, and font size is 14. So if we are using any figures in a report, then a figure must be numbered chapter wise, should appear below the figure, and font size is 10. For tables, it must be numbered chapter wise, should appear below the above the table, and font size is 10. And all equations are numbered and it should be right justified. Header and footer should be what here? Times New Roman, and page number should appear bottom right corner of every page, and references numbered serially in order of their occurrences in the text. Their number should be indicated within the square bracket. Okay, so now we will follow all these guidelines for preparing a seminar or project report. Okay, so I will consider a raw report, and I will apply all the guidelines specified by the university for preparing a formatted seminar or project report. Okay, so this is a raw report. So I want to make this as a chapter 1, and this is a chapter title, and this is a section. Okay, in first chapter we have a section like introduction, and motivation is a second section, and within the motivation section I want to make one subsection, and next this is a chapter 2. So within this chapter 2 we have a first section as objectives, and second section as a methodology, and we have a figures in a chapter 2. We have two figures, and we have two tables in a chapter 2, and after that the applications section. So this section I want to make it as a subsection which is under the second section of the chapter 2, and after that we have a references section. Okay, so now let us apply all the guidelines given by the university for preparing the seminar or project report. So first I would like to make this title as a chapter 1. So to make the this as a chapter 1, select this text and go to multi-level list. So here you click on this particular option. So here it has been given as, so chapter 1, under chapter 1 different sections will come. Okay, so click on this. So now this is what here, a chapter 1, and increase the font size of this chapter 1 to what here, 16. Okay, so next this is a section. So just you select this text and go to multi-level list. So within this you click on this option. So this is a section 1. Okay, and now this is a section 2. Again select this text, go to multi-level list. So here you select this particular option. So now this is a section 2, and now if you want to make this particular part as a subsection of section 2, so then select this text and click on increase indent option. Okay, and after that go to multi-level list. So here you select this particular option. So now what happened, this is a subsection inserted under the second section of the chapter 1. So now click on alignment left here. So this is a subsection. Okay, so now I want to make this as a chapter 2. So select this text, go to multi-level list option. So here you click on chapter 1 heading. So here chapter 1 has appeared. So click on this icon, right, and select option continue numbering. So now this became what here, chapter 2, and increase the size of this chapter as a what here, that is to 16. Okay, so now this is what here, the first section under chapter 2. Select this text, go to multi-level list. Okay, so within this you click on this option. Okay, so here we are getting what here, the number as a 3, because it is continuing from the chapter 2. So therefore select this text. So go to option increase indent, right? So now it has come 2.2, but it should be 2.1 because this is the first section under chapter 2. So just you select the bullet here and right click on this and change numbering value. Okay, so here instead of 2 you just decrease it for 1 and click on OK button. So now this is what here, the first section under chapter 2, and now I want to make this as a second section under chapter 2. So just to select this text, go to increase indent, and next go to multi-level list. So here you click on this option. Okay, so now you can change its value. So just you select this one. Okay, and right click on this and say set numbered value. Okay, so here you select these options. So this is a second section within a second chapter. Okay, and yeah, this is so this is 2.1 and this is second section. So click on this option, that is set number value. So continue from the previous list. Okay, say okay, right? So if it is not changing, then manually you set the values. Continue. So advanced value, so 2 point, this is 2 here. Okay, so now what happened, this is a second section in a chapter 2. To insert a caption for the diagram, so just you right click on the diagram and select option insert caption. Okay, and here you can select to which object you are inserting a caption. So if you are inserting it for the table, select option table, otherwise you select option figure. Okay, if you are inserting it for the figure. So now I am inserting a caption for the figure, therefore I am selecting option as a figure. Okay, and here it is appearing as a what here, figure 1, but according to the university rules, the figure and tables are numbered according to the chapter wise. So therefore you can change this this label as a what here by selecting option numbering here. So here you just say include chapter numbers, right? And so use separator. So which type of the separator you would like to use? So I want to use a period operator, so therefore I select a dot and I just click on OK, right? So now since this figure is present in a chapter 2 and this is the first figure which is present in a chapter 2, so therefore the caption is inserted in this way, that is figure 2.1. so I just give a name of the figure as a block diagram of proposed method. Okay, so now this is what here, the title, the caption of the figure. Okay, so I set it to what here, Times New Roman. The font style is Times New Roman and the size is what here, 10. Okay, so now this is what here, the first figure caption. Okay, so now what I do, I just insert another caption for the figure. Okay, so right click on this, say insert caption. So automatically what happened, the figure it has taken as a what here 2.2, because this is the second figure which is present in the chapter 2, and I just give a name of this figure as a feature extraction technique. Okay, and I say okay, right? So this is what here, the caption for the figure 2, and I change its font style to Times New Roman and size to 10. Okay, so now if you want to insert a caption for the table, so same step you have to follow. So right click on this table, say insert caption. Okay, so since you are inserting a caption for the table, select option table here. Okay, and this is table 2.1, it has taken automatically because this is a first table which is present in a chapter 2. So let me give a name of the table as a formatting guidelines, say 1. I just click on a OK button to insert the caption for the table, and so I select it as what here, Times New Roman font style, and the size is 10, and align this to what here, center. And next, to insert a caption for this second table, just right click on this table and select insert caption. So here automatically it has taken 2.2, table 2.2, because this is a second table which is present in a chapter 2. So give a name of the table as a formatting guidelines guidelines 2. Okay, and select Times New Roman, so size is a 10. Okay, so align it to center, right? So now I want to make this as a what here, subsection. So this is a subsection under section 2 of a chapter 2. Okay, so just select this text, and twice you click on this increase indent option. Okay, so now go to multi-level list. So here you select the option, right click on this. So go to set numbering value. Okay, so here you can set a value for 3 parts here. Okay, so this is a section. Okay, so main section, and this is a subsection, and within a subsection that is next section here, 2.2.1. okay, so now last is what here, references. So for the references, as university guidelines has specified, you have to insert within a square bracket. Okay, so just select this numbers. Okay, and go to numbering option. So within this, select option define new number format. So here you can specify the specific format. Okay, so I just keep this number within a square bracket. Okay, and click on OK button. So now all the references are inserted by using what here, the number which is enclosed in a square bracket. Okay, so now let us insert the page number. Okay, so go to insert option. So here you select a page number. Okay, so we have different options here. If you want to insert on the top of the page, select this option. So for bottom, select this option. Okay, so I select this particular option for inserting a page number, bottom right corner of the page. Okay, so now I have inserted correctly here. Okay, so this is page number 1, this is page number 2, this is page number 3, and so on. Okay, so next, to justify this text, Okay, so select all this text and click on justify option right. So justify option, okay. So I select all the text first. Yeah, I click on justify option, okay. So right, and to insert header and footer, so go to insert option, right, select header, okay. So you can also we have different options here, okay. If you want to have a header with a bar, okay, so you can select this particular option and so I want to write a header as a speech classification report, okay. So this is my header, right, okay. And suppose if you want to insert a footer, so go to insert option, select a footer, okay. So Department of CSC, BLDEACET, PUR, Vijaypur, okay, right. So this is header and footer, okay. So okay, so now let us once again cross verify with the university guidelines to check everything has been set correctly or not, okay. So yeah, so what is the paper size? So for the paper size, yes, go to insert option, sorry, page layout option, so go to size, so here paper size is A4, and go to margin, so go to custom margins and set top as a 0.75, bottom as a 0.75 and left 1.25 and right as a 1, okay. And next chapters, so chapter font should be what here? The chapter font should be say 16, okay. Yeah, it is 16 now. And title of the chapter, so this is the title of the chapter, okay. Set it to what here? Say 18, right. And next, section size should be what here? 16. So this should be Times New Roman. Set it to 16, okay. Set it to 16. And okay, and next, this is a chapter, so 18, and next, this is a subsection, Times New Roman, so this should be 16, okay, and yeah, the subsection should be what here, 14, right? And I think everything is correct, okay. So we have inserted a table according to the chapter wise, okay. Table caption and figure caption is inserted according to the chapter wise, okay. Thank you for watching this. Hope this would be useful for you for formatting your seminar or project report. Thank you.